this is a stinker. What's in my camera bag? Once in a while, I like to sit down and evaluate the contents of my camera bag. I do a lot of gear reviews on this channel. And you know, as you grow, as you progress, as you realize what you need, what you don't need, and the technology, when it changes and develops constantly, some of the items stay and some of the items go. Well, this year, the content of my camera bag and the bag itself changed drastically. And I gotta say that at this point, I think that it is almost perfect for what I need. Almost perfect. I'm going to show you my YouTube and social media filming and photography kit, which helps me to create all the content here. And you never know, if you're still looking for some gift ideas, maybe this will help. I'm going to start with the obvious, the camera bag. I'm using the PGYTECH OneMo backpack. I reviewed this one a few months ago. Few of you keep asking me if it's still a good backpack, if I recommend it, what my experience has been. I gotta say that I put it through the test. I've been taking it everywhere with me. It went through mud, it went through some stuff, and there's no scratches, there's no tears, nothing. It holds perfectly. It is super comfortable on my back. I used to probably buy a very terrible bag because this one is a whole different story. And it's got so many pockets that few times I thought I lost something, but then, like lens cap, but then actually I found it in one of those pockets, like last night, for example. So, what's inside? The main camera I use is the Sony a7 S3, and the lens which is attached to it most of the time is the Tamron 17-28mm f2.8. It's great for vlogging. I can get wide shots, but also medium range shots. Next lens I bring with me is also Tamron 28-75mm, also f2.8. I'm saving up for Tamron telephoto lens 70-180mm, which would be ideal to have the complete range I need. But since I do have Canon 70-200mm f2.8, I'm able to use it on Sony camera with Sigma MC11 adapter. I use it mostly for photography because the autofocus is great there with this adapter. But for video, it's only manual focus, so I don't use it that much with this camera. Inside of the camera, I have two memory cards. My choice was to go with the Lexer 128GB SD card. The other one I have is also Lexer SD card. This one is 64GB though. I have it there just in case I ran out of memory on the first one. By the way, all the items I'm mentioning in today's video are listed in the video description below. Right beside my camera are batteries. I do carry one extra battery for Sony. And if I need to bring my second camera, I place batteries from that camera there as well. On the other side, beside the Tamron lens, I have Freewell filter case with all the goodies and also a few cleaning clothes. Inside of the pouch, I have here Freewell variable ND filter 2-5 stop. Another one is 6-9 stop. Mainly for photography, I have here Tiffen polarizer. Then currently very trendy glow mist Freewell filters. One is 1/4 and the other one is 1/8. Those I will show in future video. Some of the filters are 77mm because I was using them with my Canon lenses to make them fit on Tamron lenses, which are 67mm thread. I bought just a cheap step down ring. And of course I carry also Freewell magnetic lens caps, so I don't have to take the filters down, just snap it on and all is protected. For filming on the go, for everyday filming, I don't really bring my gimbal with me. Unless I know I'm gonna be shooting something specific and it's gonna be a lot of it when I'm gonna be walking and running and all that. To help stabilize my footage, I bring Peak Design slide camera strap. Now, if you are thinking about gift ideas for any camera, this would be it. I never used it before. I bought it a couple weeks ago. I should have bought it a long time ago. You just slide the camera in when you need it and slide it out when you don't need it anymore. I really do highly recommend this. Absolutely. When it comes to sound for outdoors, I just use Rode VideoMic Go for now. When it comes to sound, I'm still not 100% happy. I'm still searching the right products. I'm still looking for the right microphones for my use, but I'm working with what I have right now and this will do. I do also use Comica Boom XD wireless lavalier microphone when I need to talk away from the camera. The only issue is that when I'm using the lavalier microphone with the Sony camera, every time I start speaking, first few words are louder and then it gets to normal level. I don't have that really happening with the Canon M6 Mark II, but I have Sony camera only for a few weeks. So maybe there's some settings I need to change. There's still lots I need to figure it out. Next important camera I have in my bag at all times is the Insta360 ONE R module camera, and the one I have on is the 360 camera, not the wide angle lens, for a few reasons. I shoot alone and I don't have that much time to position another camera to capture behind the scenes for my social media and all the stuff. So with this thing though, I just literally stick it anywhere. I know it's recording everything around me and I just choose later in the post those shots I need. Also, I live in a city which has small airports, so I cannot fly a drone here. It's not possible. So for that reason, I carry in my car at all times the extra long selfie stick so I can get those extra shots from above. I just attach it to this Insta360 camera. It works well for me. Also in the back, I have here just a short selfie stick for this camera and universal tripod. If I would be filming outside of this town, somewhere where I can actually fly a drone, I know that my choice would be to go with the DJI Mini 2. It is on a shopping list, somewhere in the lower portion. One more item I keep in the car at all times for outdoors, and that is my old tripod. I use that one only for outdoors as it is super light, and I don't mind carrying it with me. It is the Cameron T210PH, but again, it is very old. I'm not sure if they're still selling it. When I'm vlogging, I'm using the Joby Gorilla Pod, but to be honest, I don't vlog with the Sony camera as much because it's simply heavy. If I'm vlogging, I use Canon M6 Mark II because it's such a lighter camera. If you're gonna be getting Joby Gorilla Pod, if you're gonna be getting it for heavy camera like the Sony one, make sure you get the heavy duty one. They have a few different kinds. You need to get the right support for the weight of your camera. And that would be the basic setup, what I need all the time. I do also suggest carrying in the bag one of these small, very light V-Light RB08P LED light. You just never know when you might need it. The rest of the kit really depends on what I'm filming. If I need to use two cameras, then I bring the one which is filming right now, and that is Canon M6 Mark II with Viltrox 23mm f1.4 lens and simple variable ND filter. And like I said before, that camera actually I prefer for vlogging because it's so small and it's so light. And if I'm filming a tutorial when it comes to smartphone filmmaking, then I leave the Canon camera at home. I use iPhone 12 Pro and bring whichever gimbal I need to work with. I hope you found this video useful, especially if you are still looking for some gift ideas. Give it a thumbs up if you did. And if you want to subscribe to future videos, if you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hi or ahoy, which is hi and bye in Czech language, leave it in a comment section below. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao, ahoj.